you to know that I will not sleep until this person is found. I hope they get you, and I hope they make you pay for a long, long time.
And tonight, a major break in the case coming down on Issues Live as we are reporting it. In fact, right now we have a reporter going through information that's been written information released by police down there in Florida, and he's going to update us in a second what he's finding in that report that's just released. But suffice it to say, the law enforcement has arrested 24-year-old named Jared Carroll, and he's being held on 29 counts of child porn. They found him in Mississippi, even though little Summer disappeared in Florida. He supposedly lived in a building right near from where little Summer disappeared. They were going through that building all day. It's a private home. His bail tonight set at $1 million. So this is a huge development in the case, a person of interest in the disappearance of precious Summer. Lynn, Canada, your question or thought, ma'am?
Oh, hi, Jane. First, I want to send my condolences to Dana Thompson. And at the same time, I want to tell her God bless her in her battle. My comment and question is, I wonder if he is affiliated in the Haley Cummings case, or if it's possible. And my next comment is that I think that it's wonderful that Ellie went to that dump and found Summer. And I think it's very unfortunate that the landfill that was checked in the Haley case was very vague. It is said that Ellie roped off an area and checked the residential garbage that had accumulated one day in that week after she went missing. And I think it's a tragedy because if she's there, so is all the evidence. All
right. Well, I think you raise a lot of good points, and here at Issues, all of our staff offers condolences to Summer's mom, who has suffered so much, and Summer's twin brother, as well as her 10-year-old sister, all of whom have been beating themselves up simply because this little child made the deadly mistake of just skipping a little far ahead of them and never came home. Michelle Sigona, this terrible crime against Summer happened in Orange Park, Florida. Could there be possibly any connection to the disappearance of Haley in Satsuma, Florida?
Well, it appears to be about 3 hours away, Jane. That's about the total travel time at this point. And I'm sure that investigators in the Haley Cummings case will probably link up with Clay County to see if there's any way that this person could be involved with her abduction as well.
Goodness.
Judge Seidlin, I have to ask you, what's the process there when an arrest or a person of interest is identified in one case? Do the courts immediately, the prosecutors, start looking at other possible cases it could match up to?
They look to see if there's common threads. I was a legal advisor to the sheriff's department, and we would advise, we would train the police to look to see if there's common elements in both crimes. But I want to tell the parents of America that there's no safety in numbers, meaning when your child who's 7 and 9 is with other children of 7 and 9, these predators, these monsters, pick them off.
Guess what? We are extending our segment on this. Stay with us. More to come.